What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the past years, we covered design patterns as mentioned in the Gang of Four book. A lot of people watched and reacted to these videos, and a lot of questions were asked. However, one question stands out, and this question mentions anti-patterns. Let's start by answering, what are anti-patterns, and how do they differ from design patterns? You see, anti-patterns are commonly used solutions to recurring problems that lead to negative consequences. Unlike design patterns, anti-patterns represent practices or solutions that may seem intuitive but result in inefficiency, poor design, or other issues in the long run. They are essentially bad practices, in contrast to the proven good practices offered by design patterns. As a quick example to this definition, suppose we have a manager class and several functionalities we need implemented. These functionalities could range from employee authentication to database operations to UI rendering, etc. Now, every time we add one of these functionalities, it looks like it belongs to that manager class, and coupling all these functionalities to the single object will result in what we call a got class, which is an anti-pattern. A got class is a class that handles an extensive range of functionalities that should ideally be separated into smaller, more specialized components. Failing to do so will lead to low cohesion, high coupling, and difficulty in testing. There are numerous recognized software development anti-patterns, each highlighting a common pitfall or problematic approach in designing and implementing software systems. Anti-patterns are mainly divided into three categories: development anti-patterns, architecture anti-patterns, and project management anti-patterns. Let's zoom in on each one. Development anti-patterns focuses on coding practices, methodologies, and programming approaches directly impacting the quality, readability, maintainability, and efficiency of the codebase. These anti-patterns affect the day-to-day development process, hindering developers' ability to produce clean, scalable, and maintainable code. On the other hand, architecture anti-patterns concentrates on high-level structural design decisions and system organization. They impact the scalability, flexibility, and overall robustness of the software system. These anti-patterns undermine the coherence of the architecture, causing systems to become difficult to extend, maintain, or adapt to changing requirements. This impacts the system's ability to evolve and scale efficiently over time. Project management anti-patterns revolve around planning, communication, and team dynamics. They have a direct impact on project timelines, team collaboration, and the successful delivery of software. They hinder effective project planning, leading to delays, miscommunication, or missed opportunities to leverage existing solutions. These anti-patterns can significantly affect project outcomes, team morale, and the overall success of development initiatives. So, as a recap, anti-patterns are essentially patterns of behavior or practices that are commonly used but are ineffective or counterproductive in solving a problem or achieving a goal. They represent pitfalls, mistakes, or common traps that can lead to inefficiencies, errors, or failures in various domains, including software development, project management, and organizational structure. Recognizing these anti-patterns is crucial because it allows teams and organizations to identify and avoid these common pitfalls, enabling them to adopt more effective strategies and practices to achieve their goals. They are mainly divided into three categories, and while these categories overlap at times and certain anti-patterns may affect multiple areas, understanding these distinctions helps in addressing issues at different levels of software development. We will dedicate a video covering each category separately while focusing on the development ones, of course, and provide examples of the most common anti-patterns. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.